be here at whatever time that you have to face any schedules that you will be with the time today was well spent. Mount Vernon Davis United is an outgrowth of an experience that Loretta Hottinger and I had when we served on the Mount Vernon City Council. Even though perceptually there is a north-south divide in the city of Mount Vernon, our experience is that no matter what neighborhood we went to, the issues that people were concerned with were the same. Quality of life, issues of public safety, economic development, taxes, the issues that come together and talk about when you are at your dinner table, and when you are in your church hall, and when you are in your civic hall. Those are the issues that we found were on the minds of everyone in the city of Mount Vernon, no matter what corner of the city they came from. So we thought that it would be worthwhile to create a vehicle where everyone could come together on a periodic basis and learn from each other, share best practices, share experiences, and understand that while our neighborhoods may be different, we are all of one city, and we all have one goal, and that is to make Mount Vernon the best community it possibly could be. So that is the genesis of Mount Vernon Neighbors United. It has been successful because of the overwhelming response from all of the neighborhood block and civic associations. Whether you are in the Kingsbridge Garden Neighborhood Association, we have a newly elected treasurer here, or at the southern tip of Mount Vernon, or whether you are from the Fleetwood Neighborhood Association at the northern tip of Mount Vernon, you responded, you're here today, and you are the reason why this organization has been successful for our 6 years. This year we decided to do a one topic discussion because the oil field is on the thoughts and the lips of everyone in the city, again, no matter what corner you come from. So that's what we decided to do today. It's thoroughly irreconcilable, but there are sort of two camps of taking a little license with the English language here. There are those people who have bought into the concept of it being a track and field venue, where we have an 8-lane track that will be in a position to host a certain level of track and field events. There are others who feel that the space of Memorial Field is a finite real estate resource, like so many resources in the city of Vernon, that space is better used at the intense facility. So I think most of us in the community understand the debate, and we felt that we would be of service, not so much in fostering that debate, even though I think that it's a point in time today there will be that debate. But we felt that it would be helpful to have individuals from the respective industries of track and field and individuals from the industry of tennis talk about the benefits of those industries from not just a recreational and a cultural, but also from an economic development and a commercial enterprise, and that would inform the public discussion. But at the end of the day, a point of view is going to prevail. We're either going to have X number of lanes of track, or we're going to have X number of tennis courts, and it's going to be incumbent upon all of us to make that work. And the way that we're going to make that work is by being informed. So that's where we're going to start. I've explained to our hardworking mayor that we wanted to have this segment first. If his schedule permits, we're going to do that. I think he's as interested as all of us is hearing this. And then at the conclusion of this segment of it, we're going to ask the mayor, we're going to ask our county legislator, as well as Mr. Young, to bring us their point of view. So from an audiovisual standpoint, we are trying to just one microphone. So I'm going to have to ask the folks to set it apart. I think this segment calls for about 45 minutes. We can use that time, or if you feel that you can communicate to less, we'll make that work as well. I don't think anybody's going to object to us getting those sooner rather than later, but we'll make that happen. Do you have any questions that you need from me? First, good, thank you. Okay, so I'm going to start, don't read anything into this, Mrs. Mayor. I'm going to start here with the track. Here from Harlem,
Springfield's biggest sporting events, the Glendale Loud Sweep, which this year we had about 3,000 kids from Canada down from Pennsylvania. And every year we've had kids from Bermuda and all the way down to Virginia. Last time I was in Mount Vernon was on April 15th, tax day. My tax account is down in the Bronx, and I decided that on my way home, as I often do, stop by my old neighborhood. And I grew up on Seneca Avenue, at the Mount Vernon Seneca Avenue, down in what we used to call Heights. And I see that the neighborhood is still pristine and beautiful.
Suppose the meet entry has 80 boys
minutes each, that's a total of about 20 minutes. The entire event would take 40 minutes if you get the boys in and the girls. But with a six-lane track, that calls for 14 meets, or about 20 minutes per gender, a total of 56 minutes. Now, 16 minutes might not seem like a lot, but then when you consider we're not only talking about 100 meters, we're talking about 200 meters, the 400 meters, two sets of hurdles, and a few relays. If you add 16 minutes for each of those events, you're talking of extending a long track meet by another 1 to 2 hours, and possibly 3, depending on the number of people. As the meet director, they're not going to want to be in a place where they have to spend another 3 hours. Your average track meet alone goes about 7 hours. So if you're going to add another 2.5 hours, you're talking about 10 hours at that facility. And we're not even talking about being out in 95 degree weather, or rain, or 45 degree weather. So, bottom line is a lot of people who are looking for a venue, when they see six lanes, they are instantly going to be turned off. They want 8 lanes for an efficient track to get people in. Future meet directors will be hesitant to schedule events at a facility which would require longer hosting times. Meaning, just like on the track, to meet directors, time is of the essence. Now, cost. I'm not sure what the cost factors would be for those two extra lanes. You would have to speak with the people who are the architects and the builders of the facility in terms of the money allotted for that. At White Plains, I'm happy to say that we never considered 6 lanes. We were always ready for 8 lanes, and in fact, at one point, we were considering a 10-lane. But the fact that here is a smaller geographic area, like a bowl, we just couldn't do it. Now, facilities. How many opportunities for track meets are there? Just on the high school level, we are always looking for a new venue for the county championships. We have the Class A championships. We have the Class B and C championships. We have a state qualifier. These are all venues just from our area. But you have county, you have New York City schools, you have colleges, you have open organizations, all who want a facility to run. Well, what kind of money comes in from one of these track meets? All right, the blended routes mean we have usually $45,000 worth of entry fees that come into our meet. This year, over our 2-day meet, well, it's actually a 3-day meet, but 2.5 days, our revenue for selling apparel, we sold $15,000 worth of t-shirts and sweats. So you're talking about a lot of money that comes in. Our food, we sold close to $15,000 worth of food. Alright, so you're talking these track meets with hundreds and hundreds, and in some cases thousands of kids, brings in a lot.